3, here's what's making news right now.
A man is stabbed in the face on board a southbound subway train as it pulled into College Station.
It was a lot of blood.
A suspect is under arrest.
We have 7 vehicles involved in this collision.
A multi-vehicle crash shuts down a section of eastbound 401 Express lanes and sends 2 people to hospital with critical injuries. Dozens of people remained out of their homes after an explosion and fire at a Mississauga strip mall. A section of Huron, Ontario remains closed for the investigation.
The defense felt threatened by an Indigenous person being on the jury.
The family of Colton Bushy meets with ministers on Parliament Hill to call for change in our justice system. Maple Leafs are playing their best hockey of the season. Tonight they will host the NHL-leading Tampa Bay Lightning. We'll also tee up day number 4 for Team Canada, Sports at 15. There's the closing bell on Wall Street. It's a big comeback Monday for the markets. The Dow up 408 points. The TSX up 207. Business at 26. This report brought to you by Carlton Cars. Well, it's a mess out there. Eastbound 401 jammed from the 410 and the collectors to the South 427 ramp. And then all express lanes closed, as you just heard, from Kipling to east of the 400 due to collision cleanup. Eastbound 401 jammed from Dixie and the express east to Kipling collectors over to Weston. Then much further along, you'll find delays through Salem, again from the 412 to Broad Street. This is also jammed up the eastbound 409 from the 427, and then the ramp to the east 401 express obviously closed. Northbound 427 jammed from approaching Dundas and the express right up to the east 401 ramp. North 427 delays continue from the 409 to Finch. Watch out on the northbound 410 approaching Corky Park in the collectors. We have a ladder in the 2 center lanes. MTO has been notified. They're on their way to pick it up. North 410 delays continue from Steeles up to Queen. Westbound 401, the slow through Dixon and heavy from Leslie, alternately expressing collectors to west of Weston. And west 401 delays continue from here, Ontario, in the collectors to west of Mavis. And west 401 delays continue from Winston Churchill through to Trafalgar. The westbound Gardner, solid from the DDP to west of Strawn, again from Parkland to Royal York. Carlton Cars has the right words for the right moments, because moments matter. Send Valentine love and save $2 with a coupon at carltoncars.ca. With the forecast, here is meteorologist Farah Dalasingh.
Well, after a snowy weekend, I'm happy to report that we'll be seeing what will maybe feel like spring for the middle of the week. Well, not quite, but much warmer. We are seeing daytime highs above freezing for Wednesday and for Thursday. But for tonight, it will be quite chilly, a low near minus 12, feeling like minus 19 overnight. Tomorrow morning, also starting the day off cold with what will feel like the minus mid-teens. But for the afternoon Tuesday, we warm to minus 5 with a mix of sun and cloud. Here's the good news. We get into southwest wind for Valentine's Day, and a high of near plus 4 under a mostly sunny sky. Thursday is continuing to be warm with a high of plus 5 and partly cloudy, but it does cool down by the end of the week, so this warm-up is temporary. Right now it's partly cloudy and minus 3 in downtown Toronto. That's the same at Pearson. Tonight, mostly clear, the overnight low, minus 12. 680 News Time, 4:03.
With breaking news on a scary start to the week on the TTC. Police have arrested one person following a stabbing at College subway station. It may have been a random attack.
Mercedes Kevin Meiser joining us live now from the scene. Kevin?
Well, Charlene, Toronto police do say this stabbing does appear at this point to be unprovoked and random, with the suspect suddenly turning on a fellow subway passenger as the subway train was rolling into College Station here. Sergeant Steve McGran says the suspect and then the victim do not appear to know each other.
At this point, we don't believe so.
Now, this man actually saw the victim getting stabbed in the face with what appeared to be a screwdriver.
I think it was near the nose, because when he was bleeding, it was a lot of blood from the nose and from the mouth.
Police are confirming the victim also suffered a wound to his chest. He's in hospital in serious but stable condition. The suspect didn't run away. He actually stayed on the platform until police arrived. He has also been taken to hospital for an assessment. At College Station near Young and College, Kevin Meisner, 680 News. 680 News Time, 4:05. Happening now on the 401, major traffic snarl up.
up to the west end. All eastbound express lanes remain closed from Kipling to east of the 400 following a serious multi-vehicle crash. Phil Martino joins us live with the latest from police, Phil.
James, images from the crash show one of the cars involved with the front end completely destroyed, basically a heap of mangled metal. Police say that driver walked away with minor injuries. Two other vehicles have been taken to hospital with critical injuries, but not life-threatening. OPB Sergeant Kerry Schmidt tells me seven vehicles were involved in total, three of them transport trucks. It happened on the 401 eastbound express lanes near Islington around noon. He describes it as an absolute mess.
So we're still investigating. We're still appealing for any witnesses. This may be two separate collisions, or it may be one expansive collision with all vehicles involved. We're still trying to determine exactly what precipitated and what started this chain reaction wreck.
Eastbound 401 express lanes are shut down between Kipling to east of the 400. There are heavy delays in both directions. Police say the closure is expected to stay in place until at least 6 tonight. Phil Martino, 680 News. It could be a few days before people are allowed to return home following an explosion and fire that leveled part of a strip mall in Mississauga. Dozens of people were forced out of their homes yesterday morning. 680's Irene Preckler joins us with the latest. Mississauga's fire chief says about 50 people forced from their homes are now staying at a local hotel. Chief Tim Beckett says a number of things must be done before they can be allowed to return.
The building's been cleared by our building staff and inspectors as being safe, but we've now got windows that are blowing out, and all those need to be rectified before we can move people back in.
Natural gas service has to be restored to the area as well. Here, Ontario, between Dundas and Hillcrest will remain closed for at least the rest of the day as the Ontario Fire Marshal investigates. Beckett says it's too early to say what caused the explosion. I'm Irene Preckwitt.
6:30 News Time 407. Sentencing hearing for two men convicted of killing a Toronto woman has been told her family hates them for taking her life when she should be laughing and dancing. The victim impact statement for Laura Babcock's mother and brother read out in court today at the hearing for Della Millard and Mark Smith. Both are found guilty of first-degree murder in the presumed killing of Babcock, which carries an automatic sentence of life with no chance of parole for at least 25 years. The pair have also been convicted of the same charge in the death of Tim Bosma. The judge will have to decide whether to make the sentence concurrent or consecutive, which would mean they'd not be eligible for parole for 50 years.
At Toronto City Hall, debate continues on the $11 billion budget. 680's Moman Qureshi joins us live from City Hall with an update. Moman?
Charlene, council still trying to figure out how much property tax you should be paying this year in the city of Toronto. Now, the mayor's budget committee is proposing a tax hike at the rate of inflation of 2.1%, but there are some councillors, like Derrida Zek, who think it should be more.
So this is an election budget. It's a band-aid budget. But more important, it's an unsustainable budget. And that really concerns me.
Both councillors are arguing that want a higher tax rate, say that there's things that need to be paid for the city, and a rate of 2.1% just won't cut it. But the mayor has been adamant that he does not want to raise taxes above the rate of inflation, so it looks like that's what will likely be coming down the pipeline once they finally vote on it. Reporting live at City Hall, I'm Owen Correct.
To continue, time 408 is day three of the Winter Games in South Korea, and Canada adding to the gold medal count.
Day three was a golden day for Canada in Pyeongchang. Newmarket's Gabby Dalman clinched Canada's top spot in the team figure skating competition. This after finishing third in the women's free skate. Patrick Chan dominant in the men's free prior. Canada was guaranteed the gold even before Virtue and Moyer skated their free dance. Then in Mogul, six-time World Cup champ Mikhail Kingsbury captured gold with a score of 86.63 in the third and final run.
Coming here, I knew I was a big favorite, and there was so much here, and I could feel the pressure, especially last night and this morning. I've never been nervous like that in my whole life.
Meanwhile, Canadian snowboarder Laurie Blouin earned silver in women's slopestyle, and in mixed doubles curling, Canada advanced to the gold medal game with an 8-4 semifinal win over Norway. Caitlin Laws and John Morris will face Switzerland tomorrow morning at 6 a.m. With an eye on Team Canada, Andrew Dye, Sportsnet 590, The Fan.
Coming up in 30 seconds, the latest from the streets, we'll track gas.
680 News Time, 409.
This is 680 News.
Marino Snowfall leather is luxury, unbridled, and options for best-in-class acceleration capable of 0 to 104.8 seconds is power unmatched. The all-new BMW X3 sets new benchmarks with performance, technology, and design. Enjoy lease rates from 3.9% APR for 45 months on the 2018 BMW X3 xDrive 30i with monthly payments of $538 and $6,350 down. Offer ends February 14th. Hurry in today. Remains closed west of Royal York for a fire cleanup. Now, 680 News gas price update and Pro Predicts price won't change at midnight. Coming up in 60 seconds, traffic and weather together.
680 News time 410. At Scotiabank, we know life changes. So it makes sense that your retirement plan should change with you to fit where you are and where you're going. That's why we created the Scotia Aria Retirement Program, the only one of its kind in Canada. It's a personalized retirement solution, now with lower fees, so you can make the most of all those wonderful changes. Talk to a Scotiabank advisor today about how to get started. Visit scotiabank.com/future to learn more. You're richer than you think. Scotiabank. Now through February 15th, join Planet Fitness for only $5 down and then $10 a month. No commitment, because good things come in fives. Like high fives, five-star reviews, and five fingers for grabbing pizza. But why stop there? Join for $5 down and then $10 a month. No commitment now through Thursday, February 15th. Join in-club or online at planetfitness.ca. Planet Fitness. Be free. Join today at any area Planet Fitness, but hurry. Offer ends February 15th. Annual membership fee applies. Participating locations only. See club for details.
Time 4:11. Continuous traffic and weather together on the ones. Trevor Lau.
This report brought to you by Carlton Cards. We still have major problems. East 401 express lanes closed from Kipling to east of the 400. All express lanes are closed due to collision cleanup to the East 401 gym from the 410 and the collectors to south of the airport. Then you'll find it heavy from Dixie and the express east to Kipling and the collectors to Weston. East 401 approaching the DVP and the express. Watch over a large pothole in the center lane. Northbound 427 is also jammed because of this problem from approaching Dundas and the Express right up to the East 401 ramp. Northbound 410, watch out. Approaching Courtney Park, we have a ladder in the two center lanes. North 410 delays continue from Steele to Queen. Northbound DVP delays from the Gardner to north of Lawrence. Then North 404 heavy from Steele to north of 16th Avenue. New problems on the West 401, west to Young and the Collectors. We have the center lane block with a crash. Doesn't look like anybody's on scene yet to that one. West 401 heavy from Leslie and the Collectors over to west to Young. Then we have a new problem approaching Avenue in the Express. The center lanes blocked with a stalled truck. Westbound 401 delays from the 404 Express, the Allen and the Collectors through to west of Weston, and delays continue from here, Ontario and the Collectors to west of Mavis, again from Winston Churchill to Trafalgar. Westbound Gardner headed downtown, still solid from the DVP to west of Strawn, then again from Park Lawn to Royal York. Carlton Cards is the right words for the right moment, because moments matter. Send Valentine love and save $2 with a coupon at carltoncards.ca. With the forecast, here's meteorologist Farah Dalla-Singh.
It's partly cloudy and this evening becoming mostly clear. The overnight low minus 12, but it will feel more like minus 19 overnight. So a cold one tonight. Tomorrow morning, dress for what will feel like minus 19. In the morning, temperatures around minus 14, mostly sunny. For the afternoon, Tuesday, minus 5 for the high, but dress for what will feel like minus 10 at the warmest part of the day. The good news is, by Wednesday, we tap into a southwesterly flow, and this will allow temperatures to really bump up 5 degrees, possible the daytime high for Wednesday and Thursday, with a mix of sun and cloud, back down to more seasonal values for Friday, so the warm-up will only be temporary. In the meantime, right now in downtown Toronto, it's minus 3, feeling like minus 10. At Pearson, partly cloudy and minus 4 with the wind out of the northwest north. Tonight, we'll see a mostly clear sky and the overnight low minus 12. 680 News Time, 4:13.
Now a TD Market Minute to the Business Center. First ones in the books. How do we do, Richardson?
Good one, James. The market comeback continues. Here are the closing numbers. The Dow up 410 points, 1.7%. And this builds on a more than 300-point gain on Friday. The Dow's at 24,601. S&P up 34 points, 1.3%. The NASDAQ up 107. Best day for Bay Street in 2 months. The TSX up 207 points. 15,241. Gold up more than $10 to $1,324. Oil higher, but still shy of $60. And the loonie lower to 79.41 cents U.S. At the Business Center, I'm Richard Sutter.
Get up to $1,000 toward becoming retire-ready with TD Wealth Financial Planning, a division of TD Waterhouse Canada, Inc. Conditions apply. Offer ends March 1st, 2018. TD.com/financial planning.
This we know. Price is officially price of entry. If you don't have a competitive price, you're not competitive. But what about what you get for what you pay? Not just the vehicle itself, but everything else that comes along with it. The level of care, attention to detail, the experience and qualifications of your service team. Before you buy another car, consider buying something more. Take a moment to appreciate all that you're getting for your hard-earned money, and we think you'll agree. They may try to match our price, but they will never match our value. The Humberview Group. 20 stores, 17 brands, 5,000 vehicles, one promise. Serving our customers better each and every day. Dodge Caravan is Canada's best-selling minivan for over 33 years, and we've got over 100 of them. The place to buy this award-winning family mover is Cooksville Dodge, 290 Dundas Street East, just south of Square One in Mississauga. This is All News Radio, 680 News.
Kind of cloudy in downtown Toronto, minus 4 at Pearson with the winds feels like minus 11. Good afternoon from the 680 News Broadcast Center. I'm James Monroe.
And I'm Charlene Close. Here are the top stories this hour.
We have breaking news from the TTC. A man has been rushed to hospital after being stabbed in the head and the chest in the subway at College Park Station. It may have been a random attack. The suspect believed to have used a screwdriver for ice pick. He's in custody. Service continues to bypass that station. Breaking news from the 401. All eastbound express lanes will remain closed from Kipling to east of the 400. Following a serious seven-vehicle crash that sent four people to hospital, two with critical injuries. Lanes are expected to remain closed for a couple more hours. The full report in seconds. Time now for 680 Sports from Sportsnet 590. Is up and Alex Cicero.
All right, James, the Leafs and the Lightning go toe-to-toe at the Air Canada Centre tonight. And while Tampa Bay leads the NHL with 79 points, and Nazem Kadri says, hey, we're right there, too.
Standing-wise, we are a top team in the league. So I think, that being said, I think we earned that right to have that responsibility and to earn that respect. So, we're trying to catch the teams ahead of us, and Tampa Bay happens to be one.
And the Leafs are on a roll. They won 7 of their last 8, face-off at 7. Meantime, Nikita Soshnikov has been recalled from his conditioning loan but remains on injured reserve. GM Lou Lamoriello says he has to be cleared by Leaf team doctors before he is activated. Going to be a busy day number 4 in Pyeongchang for Team Canada. Marianne Saint-Gelais, one of 3 Canadians hunting for a medal in the women's 500-meter short track event. Our women's hockey team with a preliminary game against Finland, and at 6 tomorrow morning, Canada plays Switzerland for gold in mixed doubles curling. The Toronto Blue Jays announcing they will honor the late Roy Halladay by retiring his number 32 during a ceremony opening day, March the 29th. Jays will also be wearing a number 32 patch for the entire 2018 season. Meantime, the Jays have signed reliever Craig Breslow. It is a minor league contract. Well, they're building themselves quite the reputation.
Going into this season, in the offseason, they were going to be the X factor, the bench. And you knew what you would get from Kyle and DeMar and Serge, but what was that, and how could that young group develop would be the big, basically how far this team could go.
And there was Yahoo's Bobby Marks on Good Show. Raptors listing OG Anunoby questionable for tomorrow's game against Miami. Premier League right now, Sportsnet World, 57 minutes. It's in Chelsea maintaining their 1-0 lead over West Brom. This is All News Radio, 680 News.
680 News, time 4:18.
If life were like the new hit or miss ladder game, you would cheer when your favorite player struck out.
Right?
You'd be thrilled to bowl badly.
Yes, better ball!
And you'd miss the right notes every time you were jamming. Because in the new hit or miss lottery game, missing can be a good thing.
Win $250,000 by matching all or none of your numbers. Buy the new hit or miss lottery game in store today. Download the OLG Lottery app to watch the draws.
You probably remember borrowwithyourcar.com, the fast way to get cash with a lower credit score and rates you can live with. But if you have equity in your home and don't want the hassle of a second mortgage, presenting
borrowwithyourhomework.com.
That's right. If you have equity in your home or a paid-off car, that means fast cash with a loan that actually reports to the credit bureau to help restore your credit. Go online and apply today.
Get money quick. Just one click. Borrowwithyourhomework.com.
680 News Time, 419.
Relatives of 22-year-old Colton Bushy met with the federal cabinet ministers in Ottawa today to call for change after Friday's not guilty verdict in the trial of Bushy's shooting death.
Colton Bushy's family says justice was denied for them, and after the verdict, they have lost faith in our system. But they remain hopeful they can work with the federal government to bring about change. Colton's cousin Jade says jury selection is an issue, with all five Indigenous candidates being dismissed in this case.
Some people have stated that race has nothing to do with this process. Yet the defense felt threatened by an Indigenous person being on the jury. I think that speaks volumes.
Justice Minister Jody Wilson-Raybould says it's one of several issues the government will look into.
I know that I've had conversations with some members on the Justice Committee already.
Gerald Stanley was acquitted on Friday in Bushy's shooting death in Saskatchewan in 2016. Cormac McSweeney, Parliament Hill.
And a mysterious substance sent Donald Trump Jr.'s wife to hospital today in New York. Here's ABC's Aaron Katursky.
Police were called to Donald Trump Jr.'s home in Manhattan's east side just after 10 o'clock in the morning. His wife, Vanessa, had opened up an envelope containing a white powder. Ultimately, that powder was determined by the police to be non-hazardous, but his wife and two others in the apartment were decontaminated on scene by the fire department and then taken to the hospital as a precaution.
Police say the envelope was addressed to Trump Jr. Coming up in 60 seconds, traffic and weather together.
680 News Time, 420.
If you have unfiled taxes, this message is for you. With the Canadian economy suffering, the CRA is using state-of-the-art technology to crack down harder and faster than ever before. And it's only a matter of time until they find you. The CRA has the authority to garnish your wages, freeze your bank account, lien your house, or even put you in jail. If you made a mistake, it's not too late. Call Mark Feldstein Chartered Professional Accountants now at Pound Tax. That's the pound sign, tax. Or visit online at markfeldstein.ca.
Mazda presents the iActive All-Weather Drive event, featuring the Ajax award-winning Mazda CX-5, the best small utility vehicle in Canada for 2018, Mazda CX-9, the best large utility vehicle in Canada for 2018, and the Mazda 3, the best small car in Canada for 2018. Right now, you can enjoy 0% purchase financing on select new models, plus get a winter tire credit on all new models. Visit your local Mazda dealer or Mazda.ca for details.
The city news, traffic and weather together on one. Trevor Lauk.
This report brought to you by Fidelity Investments. We still have a full closure of the eastbound 401 express lanes from Kipling to East to 400. All express lanes are closed due to a collision cleanup. So unfortunately, East 401 jammed from the 410 to 7 to the airport and the collectors. Jammed from Dixie and the express east to Kipling collectors over to Weston. Watch out on the East 401, approaching the DBP and the Express. We have a pothole in the center lane. Eastbound 409 is jammed from the 427 over to the 401 collector rim. Northbound 427, also very slow from north of the Gardner and the Express right up to the East 401 rim because of all these problems. Westbound 401, good news. From a series of problems cleared, west of Yonge and approaching Avenue and the Express are clear, but still heavy from the 404 to west of Weston, alternately Express and collectors, and delays from here on Terry on the collectors to west of Mavis, and then again from Winston Churchill through to Trafalgar. Northbound 400 delays Major McKenzie to north of Teston, another delay north of King Road. Northbound DVP slow from the Gardner to north of Lawrence, and again approaching Steeles to north of 16th Avenue. Westbound Gardner delays DVP to west of Strawn, Park Lawn to Royal York, and westbound QEW heavy from the 427 to west of Cawthra, Ford Drive to Trafalgar, then again from Bronte to west of Guelph Line. When investing, remember, strong and steady wins the race. Ask your financial advisor about Fidelity Investments or visit fidelity.ca. With the extended forecast, here's meteorologist Farah Dalasig.
Becoming very cold tonight and for tomorrow morning with an overnight low near minus 12. But in the wind, it will feel more like minus 20. As we head into tomorrow morning, minus 14 with a mix of sun and cloud, and for the afternoon, warming to minus 5. By Wednesday, though, we are looking at a bit of a warm-up. Temperatures climbing to plus 4 under a mostly sunny sky as we get into a southwest wind. And for Thursday as well, with a high of plus 5 under a partly cloudy sky. Here's the thing, that warm-up, though, is temporary. By Friday, we return to seasonal with a high of minus 3 under a mostly cloudy sky. But the good news is that I'm not reporting any snow, so it looks like the next few days will be snow-free. Right now in downtown Toronto, it's minus 3, feeling like minus 9. At Pearson, partly cloudy and minus 4 with a wind out of the northwest. Tonight, mostly clear and the overnight low, minus 12.
Coming up the bottom of the hour, breaking news from the TTC. A man rushed to hospital after being stabbed in the head and the chest on Subway at College Park Station. May have been a random attack. The very latest straight ahead and happening now. Young Street is closed both ways from Adelaide to Richmond for a fire investigation. Again, Young closed both ways, Adelaide to Richmond for a fire investigation.
It's 80 News Time, 424.
Hi, I'm Mark Leroy, COO of Grand Touring Automobile. If there was one word to describe everything we do, it would be luxury. When you visit our brand new flagship facility at 777 Dundas Street East, you'll understand. Whether you want to step into a Jaguar, Land Rover, or even up to a Rolls Royce, you'll get world-class service and attention from the Grand Touring Automobile team. Experience luxury at the highest level at Grand Touring Automobile. Visit GrandTouringAutos.com. Exceptional luxury service. Live grand.
Leave the light on for when I come home.
We want you to get home before dinner gets cold.
Get the most up-to-date traffic reports in the city every 10 minutes on 680 News.
Coming up in 60 seconds, we'll take you to the Monday markets with Richard Southern.
680 News Time, 425.
Snow and ice don't stand a chance when you've got Acura's winter-ready performance on your side. The Acura MDX is built for Canadian winters with features like super handling all-wheel drive. Right now, get up to a $6,500 cash rebate on most 2017 MDX models. Or get up to a $5,000 cash rebate on most 2018 RDX models with standard all-wheel drive. It's time to step up to an Acura. Visit AcuraGTA.ca for details. Acura. Precision. Crafted. Performance.
Nope.
44.
Mm-mm.
47? And that's my final answer.
Guess you'll never know.
Beautiful skin begins from within. Active Collagen by Lorna Vanderhaeg helps to reduce the number of deep wrinkles after just 28 days. Active Collagen by Lorna Vanderhaeg. Available at your local health food store or wherever natural health products are sold. To be sure this product is right for you, always read and follow the label.
News Time, 426.
Now, the business report brought to you by IA Clarington Investments, Richard Southern.
Hey, James, stocks coming back to life after last week's roller coaster ride. It was a big money-making Monday. The Dow was up 410 points, 1.7% to 24,601. The industrial average fell 5.2% last week, but we started to see the recovery take hold on Friday. Dow was up more than 300 points Friday, and again, up just over 400 today, with Apple one of the best performers. Up 4%. S&P 500 gained 36 points or 1.4%, while the NASDAQ gained 107. And it was the best day for Canadian stocks in 2 months. The TSX up 207 points, 1.4% to 50,241. Restaurant Brands International gained 6.1% to $75.48 on better than expected earnings. Same-store sales, Tim Hortons, a little bit disappointing. In fact, they were flat or lower for a fifth straight quarter, but the company beat the street on strong results for Burger King and on its efforts to expand Restaurant Brands International, recently buying Popeye's Chicken. Shopify stock up 7% to $161 after the Ontario government selected the company's e-commerce platform for its online and in-store cannabis sales. First Quantum Minerals up 6.1%. The company said it would push ahead with an Alaska mining project. And after a big 10% drop last week, the price of oil gained some ground. It was up 9 cents to $59.29 per barrel. Eric Nuttall with 9 points on today's move for Texas tea.
Well, there's some encouraging comments out of OPEC where they affirmed that for, I think, the 14th month in a row, or if not longer, compliance continues to be very good with their production scheme. So it points to what should be a continuation of inventory drawdowns throughout this year. We see oil inventories reaching normal levels around May, give or take a month on either side, which is very supportive of an oil price at or above where we are today.
And energy stocks were higher. Synovus up 3.75%. Little bit of weakness for some of the medical marijuana names, mind you. Canopy Growth down $1.27 to $26.90. Canadian dollar down 79.4 cents. U.S. at the Business Center. I'm Richard Sutter.
What's your next adventure? See it, do it, live it at the Outdoor Adventure Show, February 23rd to 25th at the International Center. See hundreds of exhibitors with pre-season deals on the best outdoor gear and awesome travel experiences guaranteed to ignite your outdoor passion. Discover camping, canoeing, kayaking, hiking, stand-up paddling, climb the rock wall, learn to scuba dive, and meet experienced guides to help you plan your next trip. It's all at
the Outdoor Adventure Show, presented by G Adventure, February 23rd to 25th at the International Center.
Volvo knows there's no greater luxury than arriving safe and sound. That's why the Volvo XC90 combines the comfort of Scandinavian design with the protection of cutting-edge intelligent safety innovations, giving your family the luxury and protection they deserve. Lease a 2018 Volvo XC90 T5 or T6 from 1.9% and receive $1,000 off when you sign up at the Toronto Auto Show. Visit your GTA Volvo retailer or volvocars.ca for details.
If you are heading off to Paris, clear skies and a high of 5 degrees. Berlin, clear high of 0. Kingston, Jamaica, rain 27. And Mexico City, clear skies and 22. It's 4:30.
Number one for news in Toronto. This is 680 News.
Here are Split, Janet Domenzik and James Monroe.
Good afternoon. This is Monday, the 12th of February. For Slajana Tominsic, I'm Charlene Close.
Mix of sun and cloud in downtown Toronto, minus 4. Pearson with the wind feels like minus 11. Here's what's making news right now.
A man is attacked with a screwdriver on board a subway train at College Station.
One individual was stabbed around the face and the chest area.
Toronto police say the stabbing appears to be unprovoked.
No fatalities at this point.
Two people are in hospital with critical injuries after a 7-vehicle crash in the eastbound 401 express lanes near Islington.
City Council is figuring out how to spend your tax dollars this year.
It's an unsustainable budget.
The mayor wants a property tax hike at the rate of inflation, but some councilors think that's not enough.
And we'll tell you why the filmmakers and studio behind the film Peter Rabbit are apologizing.
Another one of those measuring stick games tonight. Maple Leafs getting ready to host the Tampa Bay Lightning. And Canada is guaranteed at least one medal on day 4 of the Winter Games. Sports 45.
The Bulls come back in the Monday trade. Dow up 400. TSX gains 200 points. And Canadians falling out of love with Tim Hortons. Same store sales of the company disappointing again. Business at 56.
Glad for 680 News. Traffic and weather together on the ones brought to you by Paramount Middle Eastern Cuisine, Airborne, and SkyMaster One. Good afternoon, Daryl Donner.
Good afternoon. We still have problems eastbound on the 401 from east to Kipling over to the Basket Weave, and the express lanes are closed. A collision cleanup probably till about 6 o'clock. M2OR on the scene, and you'll find eastbound the 401 heavy from Dixie and Express east to Kipling Collectors to Weston Road. Also watch out eastbound on the 401 as you approach to the Don Valley. In the express second lane to the left pothole, we notified MTO about that at 11 o'clock this morning. Well, 11 o'clock this morning, then eastbound on the 401 busy west main of Broad Street for the 680 Traffic Center. Trevor Long.
Good news is problems on the North 410 approaching Courtney Park have cleared. Delays, though, from approaching the 407 up to Queen. Northbound 427 is jammed. From approaching Dundas and the Express right up to the east 401 ramp, northbound 427 delays continue from Dixon up to Finch. Westbound Gardner out of downtown still heavy from the DVP to west of Strawn, and again from the Humber Bridge to Royal York. Escape to the higher taste of Paramount Middle Eastern cuisine. Try the fresh and authentic flavors in their family platter. Just $34.99 for a limited time at participating locations. Dine in only. Now with the forecast, here's meteorologist Farah Dallas Singh.
Partly cloudy this evening, but then becoming mostly clear overnight with a low near minus 12, but in the wind it will feel more like minus 19. Tomorrow morning starting off quite chilly with what will feel like minus 18. For the afternoon, though, warming to a high of minus 5 with a mix of sun and cloud. We do get into a gusty southwest wind for Valentine's Day, and that will bump up our temperatures. It's looking quite nice Wednesday, mostly sunny with a high of plus 4. Right now in downtown Toronto, it's partly cloudy, minus 3. That's the same at Pearson, but in the wind, feeling like minus 11. Tonight, mostly clear, the overnight low, minus 12.
6:30 News Time, 4:33.
Where frightened passengers watched in shock as a man was stabbed on board a subway train.
6:30's Kevin Meisner joins us live with words that this could have been a random attack. Kevin.
Well, James, the stabbing happened just as a southbound subway train was pulling into College Station here at Yonge and College. This witness tells me he actually saw the attacker turn and attack his fellow subway rider right next to the doors.
Suddenly, he punched the person who was sitting near the door. I thought that he was just fighting, but then when he was trying to punch him second time, I saw the screwdriver.
Sergeant.